10 seconds remaining. Team Empire's turn to ban. Radiant Team ban. Seconds remaining.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the lower bracket finals here at the Manila Major. The European qualifiers are wrapping up today. We've got two more teams still to earn their spots at the Major. As we already saw earlier today, Newbie as well as Mineski punched their tickets. Someone from Europe will be doing it soon. I'm LD. I'm joined here by Draskal remotely. And Draskal, crazy game two. Didn't think it was actually going to turn out that way. Looked like an Empire 2-0 sweep, but no diggity. They hang on, and they will be forcing this deciding game three as the draft is now underway.
Empire got to be kicking themselves for a few things in that last game. Primarily, just grouping up a little bit too much in the Roshan pit when the Vax stun came out from the stun. That was a fight that you and I had both thought was going to be pretty hard for Nodigity to win, but on the back of one nice combo, they were able to pull it back. And then, of course, afterlife itemization, I didn't necessarily love. And, you know, here we are, game three, a couple of mistakes later. But Nodigity actually taking the Doom away from Empire. First time this entire series. I kind of like that. I think the Doom has been a focal point for Empire as they have first picked it, obviously two games in a row, but their game plan usually revolves around having something that can punish the greed, and Doom is harder to punish than what Enigma is, which is typically what Nodigity would do. So I think it's a nice little change up here.
So generally for Empire, they've been prioritizing the Disruptor a lot, but that is the, I guess the big curveball Nodigity throw them. They do ban it out here first phase. It's a very targeted ban. Other heroes, they've really been favoring the Darkseer. We've seen a lot from Nodigity. For Empire, we have seen the Morana quite a bit, but this time Empire will go Darkseer with the Lion, so it seems they still really want to have these strong, like, fighting lineups, basically, and get a slightly different composition here, but still vacuum into the stun, just a lot of burst damage and teamfight in general. It does feel like a pretty straightforward Empire draft as far as that goes.
Yeah, I'm wondering if Nodigity just banned the Sven in the second phase. It seemed like, out of all the heroes that were left in the pool, Sven was probably the only one who could have had that much impact with like a vacuum combination, and probably one of the only reasons Nodigity were able to claw their way back into that game in general, so maybe looking for Nodigity to ban that in the second phase. If not, I don't know. Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know if they could pick it themselves necessarily, but Empire do have the first pick out of this phase, so looking to Nodigity, see if they want to do that. They got to be shaken a bit, right? Because now, like this Bane pickup, this is usually the common thing where you would take it with the Enigma if you were Nodigity, but we've already seen the fact that they picked up Doom. So are they a team that's greedy enough that picks Enigma and Doom together? Because I think that's a little bit too much, even for them.
Yeah, Nodigity now heading to the second phase here. We see Empire removing the Alchemist. I guess just seeing, you know, already the Doom and the Bane, just two heroes that can go pretty late potentially, and Nodigity have favored the Alchemist a lot. I mean, I haven't been entirely sold on it myself. Obviously, it's a strong hero, but it just always seems like they end up in these situations where they're just like kind of farming passively for the ultra late game. And you know, if your opponents don't make mistakes, like if Empire doesn't blow that fight at the Roche Pit, then almost certainly it's Empire's game to lose. So I don't know. How do you feel about the Alchemist? Do you think it's ban worthy? Do you like taking it away here in the second stage, Andy?
I think it's actually pretty good, mainly because, like, Doom, we've seen in the past, it's not really that good against the Alchemist. So Nodigity would be the team who would be picking it up anyway, and Empire don't play the hero, as far as I know. Like, I don't think Scandal, like, sure, maybe he can play it, but it's definitely not something that I think is his comfort zone. So just removing the hassle of it, I think, is nice. And I do think it has some validity in a lot of these games, because it's one of those heroes that if you leave alone for even, like, 5 minutes, he can just have, like, another item on top of your cores, and he can all of a sudden start creating pressure around the map. So it's kind of like that ticking time bomb, where I feel like, if you're Empire and you think, okay, we played better in the first two games, we just made like this one really big mistake in game two that ended up costing us, taking away those time bomb heroes is a really good way to go, because then it just means if you play your game, you should win.
And a good point about the time bomb heroes, because they ban another one here in the Tinker. We have seen teams counterpick the Tinker, like Spectre, the big hero that can do it, I guess to a lesser extent. Historically, it's been Storm, Batrider, probably a more relevant meta hero who does decently against him, but they just say, screw it, we don't want to deal with it. Let's just get that hero out of the game. No more cheesiness from No Diggity. No Diggity now going to work on their final ban, and then it'll be over to Empire for the next pick. So, looking at Empire heroes, there's still the Puck available for Scandal, the Batrider, both of his heroes in the pool. Probably his two most played, I would say, as of late. But No Diggity instead removed the Riki, suggesting they may have a jungler in mind here.
That might be a bait, though. Because, yeah, okay. They're gonna just pick the Enigma themselves. Okay, so I thought it might be a bait, because picking Doom and Enigma together is just, like, next-level greedy, right? And even if you do ban out the Riki, I think there are still ways that you can pressure the lane. But then again, I mean, maybe No Diggity would have ran that. It just seems really crazy. But I think that at the same time, Cinderin probably was assuming that this could be a valid response, you know? Just take the Enigma yourself because you have the first pick out of the phase. And it also leaves the opportunity for Empire to go back again if they want to try to go for the Sven. I think it still fits their lineup very nicely. Looks like No Diggity are going to get the Koikva and Voker. Probably going to be Exort, I would imagine, just given the fact that they don't really have a whole lot of damage right now.
And yeah, there's the Scandal Batrider to follow this up, so... They get some really good Roche potential here with the Enigma to actually take it, and the Batrider with the vision control around the pit. Pretty classic Empire draft does lead to a very hard carry for Ramzes, as they don't really have anything that goes late aside from that. On the side of No Diggity, more of like the dual core draft potentially with the Doom or a jungle Doom, and in that case, still even more cores to be picked up. And they get a good one here versus the Batrider, grabbing the Slark. But it is a hero that takes a little bit longer to come online.
Yeah, and they're not going to have access to the AM either, which is... like it's I think, a really good matchup for the AM, because a lot of the time during the mid-late game, you jump on him with Manta, you burn his mana super fast. He's pretty much forced into using the Shadow Dance right away. You can force him into a very defensive posture. And I mean, the Batrider is okay, but... not having use of a vision hero with it, they're just going to ban the Nightstalker out in the same sense, just, you know, not have to deal with the lack of vision. So they do think this is a Khezu Doom, almost 100%. Otherwise, I don't think he would ban that.
So, two heroes that really come to mind for Ramzes. One is Ember, the other is Spectre. Do you like either of those here?
I think for Ember, it's not a terrible game. Like, Doom has a pretty slow cast animation, so you can... more or less kind of juke around him, but I mean, I still think Sven is decent as well.
That's true.
Yeah. You could also go for something like a Phantom Lancer in this situation. I think PL is really solid against these, because you can use like the same juking kind of ways that you do with an Ember against the Doom as PL. You just Doppelganger or your Manta style or whatever, and you can just kind of like walk it off. Slark also naturally has like no illusion clear, and Diffusal can be really annoying, so we'll see what the ban is here from No Diggity.
Yeah, I'm hard-pressed to think of anything else. It is the Sven that gets banned. There's quick Mirana grab by No Diggity, and it looks like...
that's the Absor Mirana, right?
I think it is a support Mirana, yeah, based on the last time they ran it. Earlier today, it was a support as well.
Okay.
So it's going to be the Koikva Invoker, the offlane Doom for Khezu, and then the Era Slark.
Yeah, Empire. I mean, I think No Diggity actually have a very well-rounded draft this time around. I mean, just having the Slark for night vision against the Bat can be a nice thing. Like, a lot of... well, pretty much everyone knows that Batrider counters... or doesn't counter Slark, it's the other way around. Like, Slark can purge all the Stick and Napalm, it's really hard to get a reliable lasso. They are gonna go Spectre. Man, that is greedy. Okay, so... it does give them some kind of... time bomb, if you will, like we were talking about that for No Diggity, like getting that hero that would eventually get out of control. Spectre matches up pretty good against Slark in the late game. Desolate plus Mantha style Diffusal can be pretty devastating in the same way that AM would be kind of annoying for him. And it also gives you like that guaranteed form of initiation with the Bat, where you can get like a lasso into Haunt, and so you get the pickoff.
I mean, like you said, though, this is super greedy. They have some really long cooldown ultimates here, four heroes that need farm. I mean, even the Lion needs a Blink or at least an Aether Lens, like some form of mobility or initiation, and they take a while to come online. Doom a lot quicker to do so. The Mirana can have an impact early. It is a more of a late-game draft, and I guess we tend to see these a little bit more on the dire side, so... see how it works out for Empire. Decisive game number three, and Ad Finem, the real winners, as they get a nice rest. These teams, just a grueling game number two, and especially for No Diggity. I think it's already been, let me see here, like a 7-hour day started around 2 a.m. local time. It's about to hit 9 a.m. And they have a best of five awaiting them. So they are looking at potentially like over 12 hours of Dota. And that's if this next series goes pretty quickly. And that's assuming they get there. Empire looking to close them out now. Going to be tough.
Yeah, this is actually probably the closest draft, in my opinion, of all of them. I think last game, the draft itself was kind of close, but the laning phase put No Diggity really far behind. Still, they were able to pull it back and win. It's got to be a bit of a confidence hit here for Empire, but we'll see how they handle this third game. I mean, the heroes that they have, Spectre, Lion, those don't deal well with Doom, to be totally honest. Like,
and that's before the Morana comes to the lane. If you hit that arrow, like, what is Lion actually going to do about that?
Yeah, that's... I don't know, we'll have to see how they handle the lanes. And that's also with Yapzor, like, going into the jungle, too. It's not even just about him being in the lane, it's kind of like, how much is he going to be harassing Mapushka? Is Mapushka actually even going to go to the jungle? Because right now, he's kind of chilling bottom.
Yeah, Rune's about to spawn here, so... be interested to see if Diggity do contest this top rune. Thinking about an arrow, and it is a connection on Scandal.
Oh,
even
manages
to deny the bounty. Yapzor, what a player.
Damn.
I mean, mostly coming up big with the team fight ultimates with the Venno and the Enigma in the group stage and the early playoffs, but here it's a smaller but very significant play, denying the bounty rune, and Quakefoot will get the advantage here in mid now. No magic stick yet, but I imagine we'll be grabbing one quickly.
He wishes this game was played in the last patch because that bounty is much more impactful, giving the 100 experience that it used to. Unfortunately, that's not the case anymore, so... I mean, this matchup is, not one that we see a ton, Invoker versus Bat, but it should be one that you kind of... I guess you kind of favor the Bat for a little while, and then once the Invoker starts getting levels, it's probably going to be fine for him. Top lane here.
Uh-oh, Kezu. He's still trying to find that Devour creep, and it is an Ursa in the end. Elbear special, but bottom lane, Afterlife caught out by three, and Aerith going to get the first blood. Looks like it was a sleep into an arrow, then a quick pounce, and Darkseer not level two, so didn't have the Surge to even try to run away. Thane's looking good off the bat.
He had a ward too, so I'm kind of curious as to how he actually got caught by that. Maybe he threw it from like farther south where the ward vision didn't actually cover.
Yeah,
I guess you have the sleep as well for the long duration setup.
Yeah.
He's sweeping around though, going for the jungle arrows as he plants a ward down. Gonna kill off the Wildkin, and he's gonna ward block the camp. And meanwhile, top lane, Kezu taking some harassment for Ramzes here, as well as Kinar, but they can't quite kill off the Doom. Very durable, that one. And good news for Empire, uncontested Enigma for now.
Yeah, they're pushing the lane, though, which means Kezu's gonna be getting some out of this. Like, anytime you're playing hyper-aggressive, you just have to realize that, you know, the offlaner will eventually start getting experience, because every time you attack, you're pulling the creep aggro and whatnot, so... I think Kezu's gonna be more than okay in the situation. It's like you mentioned, does the Enigma offset the balance of having so much pressure on the mid and safe lane because of this roaming Morana?
I mean, so far it's been a pretty impactful roaming Morana here, getting a kill, denying the bounty. Dare I say it, I think the Morana's done more so far. And now drops a ward too.
Yeah, I mean, this is what you kind of have to do, I think. He's even going to steal the big creep.
This is a pretty cool way to try to deal with it. Like, you kill the big creeps, you leave the small ones. And he ward blocked the other camp too, so he is really trying to shut down this Enigma in a very unorthodox fashion.
And the other thing too is they can't really kill him either. Like, he has a built-in escape mechanism, so even if you send King R over here, it's a very low probability kill, so he can't really commit the resources. And even if he did, that just means that Kezu starts free farming the lane. Probably just starts bullying your Spectre because of Infernal Blade and how OP it is at low levels. So
now he's gonna kill the Centaur. This is actually sick by Yapzor.
Yeah.
Blowing the crap out of this Enigma. He's even pinning out, like, guys, what's going on to my jungle? Only level 3 at 3 minutes. Not terrible, but top lane, they have found Kezu. Going to work here. The Scorched Earth active. It's going to be close. I think two more auto attacks needed. They do get the hill. Off lane Doom ends up going down, and that is the power of Desolate here.
He just let himself get a little bit too low. Like, you need to be, like, above half health, I think, to live through a full combo of these heroes.
Now back to mid. There is no dire vision of this latest rotation. Looked for the D ward, by the way. Did not find it. So, two sentries planted down. One was to block the camp top. Little success here thus far as Yapzor drops another ward. Also not going to be scouted. I mean, this guy has even levels with an Enigma, practically.
Yeah, I think this is something that only Nodiggity have done, as far as I know, and the European scene. I don't think anyone else has played it, like the roaming kind of Mirana thing that we're seeing so far.
Now he grabs the DD, he leaps away. Oh, and he even goes for the arrow, it's gonna hit him, and Poshka, he hits quite hard, he's got the leap move speed. I think this is a solo kill, Sunstrike coming in, he probably gets it anyway. Yapzor's like, I'll do it myself, you can't stop me, but Poshka, one more auto attack, he has the ward vision, jukes up the hill, does get hexed, I think he can still go for it, gonna have the arrow here, he just sees through the trees, Yapzor, he wants it bad, he can turn back on Kinar potentially, not sure there's much the Enigma can do about this, the double damage, still plenty of duration here, is he gonna get the kill? Oh, the arrow's off the mark. No mana for the leap now. The leap probably could have secured it. The auto attack, not enough. 27 HP. Kinard goes for the deny. Again, the whiff sunstrike. Come on, Koikfa, help out your support. Yapzor does it solo. Almost got a double kill out of that. This Mirana is on fire.
All right. If they don't win the game, Yapzor, I feel so sorry for you, because he is making the most amount of space that I've ever seen a Mirana make in the early game. This is, like, disgusting. If he didn't get that uphill miss, he would have killed two heroes. Like, just a roaming Mirana killing two heroes by himself.
Yeah, or, you know, God forbid that he gets any help from the Sunstrikes, but bottom lane, he's now rotated in on the Afterlife. Yapzor is beyond heating up. He's officially on fire at this point. As Kanar rotates in, he tries for the stun. That's not going to connect. Era pouncy away to safety. Era gets the last hit. So now what's happened here? Looking back at the mid lane, Koikfa holding even with Scandal, so that lane's going fine. The offlane Doom is struggling a bit relative to what we've seen in some games, but I mean, it's been the Yapzor show, and it is enough right now. They're up by over 1,000 gold, over 500 experience. A really good laning stage right now for Nodiggity.
I mean, your Doom has a full level over the Darksteer. I think that's more than okay, too. Like, even considering the fact that Kezu's died, I think Afterlife has died two times now. So, all things considered, this is the early game that you're looking for. Your Slark is getting comparable farm to the Spectre. The middle lane is about even two, whereas Scandal was a bit ahead earlier, but he was pulled away from mid because how much shenanigans Yapzor was doing in the jungle.
And he has Arcane Boots already, so can just keep on flinging out those arrows willy-nilly. Minute Rune does spawn out. It's an Arcane Rune for a bat. Very potent combo here with the Sticky Napalm. 20 ops to activate it. And it will be the other thing is, I guess we didn't talk about it too much, but not only is he slowing down the Enigma, but the Enigma being in the game, it does limit the bat a lot. We're not seeing any stacking for Scandal right now, Andy, so the blink is not going to be that fast.
Yeah, it's a little bit unfortunate, but I think that's one of those heroes where even if you get a couple of minutes to yourself and your team is doing something, you can probably recover it that way. And it's a little bit shaky of a start here from Empire, but they do have some really good synergy with the Batrider initiation once he gets the Blink Dagger and the Haunt as well. And we also can talk about the fact that Ramzes is still pretty much free farming, you know? Like, no one's really pressuring him that heavily. So they're still getting what they need, it just is a little bit slower than they would like.
Oh, there is a Radiant Ward here. It does see Kanar. I believe Yapzor are also under a Dire Ward, so everybody's got vision. I don't think both teams are... Oh, that was a close arrow. Almost connected. But now Kanar wants to go in onto Kezu. Poshka joining this as well. Level 5. They do have Haunt online, incidentally. So maybe going to see that first rotation from Ramzes as he works towards his urn. Likely to have it very soon. Yeah, he's just Yapzor just eyeing Miposhka. Oh, fires the arrow again. He's leaped up onto the hill. This could be his death. They might manage to finally declaw the cat here, but Kezu working Miposhka, not level 6 just yet. They have the Doom online. Kezu could go for the 2-fer potentially, but Spectre will join this. He runs back the other way. Ice Hex controlling him for now. The Scorched Earth healing him up a bit. They do lock him down even further, and now Scandal joining the fray. They're going to get Kezu as well. So Yapzor, aggression blunted here. Kills to equalize the Enigma death, and then some.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And they still have Haunt.
The wages of fear.
See, Team Nodiggity now pushing in the mid lane. Koikfa closing in on his Midas here. And in the meanwhile, Mr. Yapzor making the journey back towards the top lane. Arrow coming through, but Spectre's still farming this one up. If we lost Andy Scriff, we might be at Draskal down here. Alright, let's see if we can get him back.
Hello.
Hello, welcome back, Dad.
This brings me back to like 3 years ago. Somebody just randomly DCing from Skype and then, you know.
My whole world falling apart.
That's okay. I didn't miss too much. I think I missed like what, one kill on each side?
Yeah, something like that. Nothing too big. But still no Diggity continuing to pull ahead here. Up about 2,000 gold, 1,500 experience. Oh, courier? I don't think Yapsor sees it. Oh, actually, he just planted the ward, so I got a brief glimpse of it. Kill the courier, too.
I mean, he's a legend if he does.
He's already pretty legendary in my book, but yeah, not going to find it this time, it looks like. Alright, so taking overall stock of the game here. Thoughts after the early laning state?
I mean, clearly no Diggity are getting pretty much everything that you could hope for. The amount of impact that Morana had, I think, is even more than what Empire were expecting, so... I mean, I guess the response here is just to try to pressure with the Enigma, but he doesn't really have anything, you know? He's just got the Soul Ring and a Black Hole. I think it's just going to end up being a trade here. Empire still needs some time. Scandal's Blink Dagger is key here.
Afterlife is going to cut the wave, and he will clear out the creeps with the Ion Shell. Meanwhile, no Diggity moving in onto Ramses. Don't see him, though. Just that little black cloud behind the trees. Oh, they either know, I think they actually, no, they haven't seen him yet, or have they? Now they have. Ramsey's forced to dagger, runs away. That will be the tower dropping. Looks like Era's gonna bring it down. What kind of Slark build are you expecting this game? We've seen a lot more like hard carry builds out of Era lately. Is this the Midas, the Shadow Blade, Blink Dagger?
I really like Blink in these scenarios, when you have a team that can actually like fight. You have like this Bane, Exort, Invoker for Sunstrikes, really good setup and follow-up damage, but he's gonna go the Shadowblade. It's also a pretty standard item on him. It's usually like the choice between Blink, Shadowblade, or Midas. Those are the first items that we almost always see on him. The nice thing about Shadowblade in this game is, obviously you can purge off your own dust, you know, if you get a cast on you with Dark Pact, and when the tier 1s are dead, sometimes it can be a bit scary. Applying against the Shadowblade, but King R living life on the edge here, just doing some aggro warding.
And the hate Sunstrike comes out to counter it. So.
Has he missed all of his Sunstrikes, by the way? I'm pretty sure he has.
Yeah, he's missed three. No. Actually, Andy, that's not fair. He hit the one in the fountain at the start of the game.
That start of the game, yeah.
So he's
that's
one
the
four.
Dota buff padding Sunstrike right there.
25% hit right here, but yeah, as far as the ones that matter, you know, yet to hit one. They do have good setup. They got the Bane grip, the sleep, the arrow if Yapsor continues to hit them.
I mean, that was the thing about the Enigma not dying, right? Is he cast Sunstrike like super late when the Enigma got arrowed in the river. The Poshka was going like towards Top Rune and they missed a kill because of that too, so hopefully he can be a bit more on point.
Yeah, maybe he didn't realize that like that was actually a kill, but Yapsor with the DD just hit like a truck. So now we do see the blink, a bit slower for the Batrider Scandal, but he's got it now. Haunt is online. We're gonna smoke for Empire. They head towards bottom. They do have vision on... Who else? Sindarin.
Poor Sindarin, dude.
Poor guy.
I mean
it seems only fitting that he keeps on dying and the team somehow winning.
Okay, he is actually... If they go to the right, he was mega dead, but they want the higher priority target.
Yeah, the mercy for Sindarin, but only because they feel it's the better way to win the game. But they might get nothing out of this. See? I mean, with Cinder in there, you've got to figure it's safe as Invoker, right? But oh, he walks right into it anyway. He's still gonna die. Oh, poor Cinder. I mean, honestly, much better than the Invoker dying, but...
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the thing is, he probably knew that there was a good chance that he was gonna die doing that. But at the same time, you know, it relieves pressure from the other heroes. It means that Kezu's feeling not super safe, but he realizes that he's not going to get Batrider initiated on at least, and they do have Doom available, so maybe they look for a setup here.
Oh, nice. Lane Ward gets planted down. Empire could be in a lot of trouble. They've got the Arrow of the Doom online as well. You can go on Miposhka, quick Arrow, that'll connect. Now the Scorched Earth, the Doom not being committed here. Oh no, we'll drop it. Okay, Miposhka down. Wasn't sure if he was going to use it, but they will take the free Enigma kill. Ramsey's sticking around through this. I'm not sure he realizes that Cinderin's also arrived. Now the net comes out, the grip from distance, the arrow as well. The Sun's like, this one's gonna hit, and Koikfa. Oh, he gets on the board.
You know, it's not the Sun Strikes that you miss, LD. So you're gonna miss everyone you don't throw. That's how it works. Sometimes you need a Fiend's Grip. It's not a big deal. Everyone has an off
game. And an arrow. And a net.
And a net. Just every disable.
That was like watching four guys like hand a basketball up a ladder and then drop it in.
That's how I get my layups. People just hand me something when I'm on a ladder.
The problems of an old man. I know them all too well.
Yeah, it's rough.
You know I'm turning 30 this year, right? That's like 530 years.
You got a foot in the grave, man. See you later.
Yeah, as much as people call Fear the old man, I'm actually older than him. So.
Yeah, I think I am too, actually, by a few months.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah.
Just get the wheelchairs out.
Dude, I'm ready.
I mean, speaking of which, you know, in Dodi or Cinder, and he's getting up there too.
Yeah, it's true.
All these young bucks on the team. But it's working out so far. 6-4 the score, no diggity. Here comes the Haunt, though. They have lassoed Yapzor mid lane, and it will be the Morana going down. So Ramzes, he gets his first earned charges of the game. But it's a pretty big commitment to get a Morana kill. They'll take it as Empire, but again, it's not the high priority here is going down for no diggity. Still, no deaths on the Slark. The Doom died earlier, but not as of late, and the Invoker yet to drop.
Yeah, we haven't really seen any utilization of Black Hole either from Apushka. It's a really hard game for him, I think, to get going. Like, he was being pressured pretty heavily in the jungle by Yapzor. Hasn't really gotten to the mech just yet. So they're not really able to push either because his itemization has slowed quite a bit. And I mean, the Darkseer, he's sitting on like 1800 gold, so we don't know if he's going for like a straight up blink dagger. Is he going to go for like a pipe? It's like decent against their lineup, but not great. Still yet to be seen.
So it seems like for Empire, pretty much they just want to fight around like the lasso as well as the haunt. How do you expect No Diggity to play this moving forward?
I think they want to actually fight around Knight, because Slark Night Vision is super good against these heroes. When you know that they want to try to initiate on you with pretty much only the Batrider, like that is their primary mode of starting an engagement. It's like lasso into haunt, then we fight. But if you don't allow them that opportunity, I'm gonna see a Doom.
Doom onto Ramzes. Yapzor with the long range arrow. The creeps, they don't cooperate. They are trying to cut him off with arrow, perhaps. Has the Shadow Blade under the Moonlight Shadow. He goes, and he's going to take the free courier kill instead. Nice little double poke there, secures it. Oh, Cinderin, he's in pretty far here. He's going for the TP out, and that is simply not happening. Tries for the self-deny, also denied that as well, and will get dewarded. That could have been a freebie, but Cinderin a bit out of position.
That was a little bit strange. Like, why was he running in that direction? That's my question. I mean, obviously he dropped the ward, but still.
Uh-oh. No, this is not good for No Diggity. Yapzor, I mean, it's one thing to lose Cinder in there. Not ideal, but two supports for a courier doesn't feel really that worth it. Grafska is not worth it at all.
If there was, like, some big item on the courier, maybe it would have been okay. I guess it does delay the mechanism purchase on Apushka. He's almost got enough money for it now. So... probably not at the end of the day, an overall worth for the courier versus the two kills. But it's not like Empire can turn around and kill Roshan or anything. Like, that seems to be a consistent theme in the qualifiers, at least in the EU region, is the lineups outside of maybe like Adfinim, they're not really good at killing Rosh, so you have to wait for much longer periods of time before you start to see a team do that.
Oh, Kezu, he jumps directly into the entire enemy team, but there's a black hole here too! Oh, Cinder there to save them, but is it even a save? It might be too late! The damage is almost overwhelming, it's up to Era to turn this one, but they've instantly lost three. They're lucky not to lose four. They just TP'd in some chaos, and they get slaughtered. They also give Ramzes the tower up to 1700 gold. Era missing on the pounce now. Can they turn this? Malephus, he's dead too! It's four down! No Diggity throwing the lead away just like that! It's a 5000 gold swing! What is going on?
I think that's what we call an Impale Vacuum Black Hole all on top of each other, and then Era deciding that he didn't want to be alive anymore. I honestly don't know why he leaped like that. Like, they're already in a position where the Slark has a ton of farm, right? So going into the late game as a Slark against this team, you're actually feeling pretty okay. The only way you really die is if you get caught by a black hole or the lion jumps you with the bat. You know, those are ways that you get caught out. But realistically, as Slark, you're not going to get caught, so you don't need to play super aggressive at this stage, especially when your team is already dead. I think it's just a little bit of nerves maybe getting to them.
Well, those kind of mistakes, I mean, you mentioned Empire's draft on the greedier side of things, but you have one or two good fights like that in the mid game, and suddenly your Darkseer gets his first big item, four staff arcane boots up, Batrider working towards his third here with the gem, blink force, and probably the BOTs coming next. And more importantly, Ramzes up to 2400 gold. They can't afford too many more mistakes like that, or this Empire late game draft is going to come to full fruition.
Yeah, the Radiance is going to be super terrifying for no Diggity's heroes. Like, none of them are really built to sustain through that kind of, you know, Radiance burn damage. Like, just popping it into a fight, having the dust available too. That's one thing about Spectre that's really nice against Mirana, actually, is you're an amazing dust carrier. Because you can just go into the fight with Radiance on, just pop it, and you reveal pretty much the entire team, depending on where you go. And then it's, like, guaranteed that you're going to slow them as well. Because you can't really, like, stop the invis unless you're attacking people. Just a nice little mechanic there, but yeah, Empire feeling pretty solid right now in their current position. It's not like the Invoker and the Sark aren't farming. It's more just you can't take team fights like that. You just need to make sure that Era's always out on the map doing something.
Well, no Diggity. Definitely not feeling as confident. You can kind of see it in their movement here. Much more tucked away on their side of the map, even though the Black Hole, the Finger on cooldown, just farming up a bit. Looks like they want to slow the pace of the game down, but that does give Empire some more breathing room in their own right. It looks like Ramses will be going for that relic, up to 2,800 gold. Gandalf signing back for the time being, but might be finding the Slain Ward mid very soon. And also worth mentioning, Kanar did just get his Aether Lens off of that. So the items are starting to come in. The Enigma mech just picked up, 1,500 gold on top of it. They're all at least getting the back-to-school basics here.
Yeah, this is a scary timing too, because Gem, Blink Dagger on Bat, they can catch out anyone pretty much. They need to get the heck out of Dodge, bottom line. There's no way you want to stay here. It's not even a tower.
See, you say get out, Cinder says go in, charges at them, and immediately caught by the Surge. Oh no.
Alright, so I can forgive a lot of the deaths this game that he's had. Even the one in the Dire Jungle, I would say, was okay. That one was a feat. Like, the Yavsor just says, I'm out, see you later. And then Cinderin, like, tries to walk to the side shop. Even he has, like, TP Scroll in his inventory and he still walks over there.
Well, he's gonna try to educate himself on how to avoid these feeds. He's just purchased a fresh tome of knowledge. Maybe the answers he needs are in there.
Yeah, first page it says, stop dying. That's pretty much how it works.
Run away from enemies, not towards them.
Yeah, I mean, it's actually kind of crazy because, like, every single time he walks in a bizarre direction, it feels like he should know, because of, like, four members of Empire are not showing on the map, and your other support TP is away. That's usually the cue to just leave, right? But, yeah, at least he revealed all the heroes that were there, and it does allow Era in the top lane with Quaker making his way up there too to pressure.
Yeah, I mean, that's at least, like, two avoidable deaths that ultimately aren't really worth it. It's like, there's still that silver lining of, well, they know where the heroes are, so they can split push, or at the very least, the rest of the team definitely gets out safely. Yeah, they probably live anyway, but it could be worse, Andy. At least he's the fighter.
Yeah, no, I mean, sometimes it's actually better to die and give the vision. But, you know, it's still a very close game, in my opinion. I think the Slark still has the opportunity to get a little bit out of hand, and dealing with him in the later stages is going to be tough. You know, Batrider initiations aren't super reliable against him, especially at nighttime. You're kind of, you know, you're going to need this really perfect initiation to be able to take him down.
Ooh, look at this. So Ramses is not going into a Radiance. He's actually gone back for a Yasha, up to 2,000 gold. Slark has completed the Silver Edge, which, correct me if I'm mistaken, this completely counters both of Spectre's passives, right?
Yep.
You get it all.
Yeah, it halves the damage as well, I think. Didn't they increase it by like 10%, I think? Yeah, enemy damage reduction by 50. Now it used to be 40. So they kind of just like kinda sort of buff the item because it's better for other heroes. I still think that ult
Silver
Edge.
I guess in theory it really shuts them down.
Yeah.
I think we may have lost you again.
Am I still here?
Goodbye,
Hello?
Sweet Draskull.
Uh oh.
We're trying to bring him back. In the meanwhile, this will be a one man show here. Hopefully not for the teams though. No Diggity, undercover of smoke, moving in bottom lane. There are the man in front. Actually, now it's Cinderin leading the way. He is getting rather close. He plants down the lane ward. It's a good one. It actually scouts Empire smoking. No Diggity. They might get the jump. It's not the wards you miss. It's the ones you hit potentially here as they look to move in. Era gonna jump forward, but actually they pounce away at the right moment. It's Kezu who gets hecked, caught out by Kinar with the quick draw reaction. And now the Batrider scrambles back, looking for Era. There's the two arrows done. Now the Black Hole, the Deputy Blaster cancels, the Meteor rolling through, on to four heroes, and Afterlife doomed in the backside, but Ramses begins to clean up. They got just enough out of that Black Hole. Three are down. The Slark also dead. Make it four. They had the opening. They thought they could take it, but it ends with the majority of the team hitting the deck. chaos and destruction in the end. It looked good there, but didn't come through for no diggity.
All right,
Team Empire with that team fight win. Now Ramsey suddenly completed Manta style has been delivered. Very likely the Diffusal Blade to be built up next, and Koikpa. Well, it's time for the split push here. Up to the top lane. POT's in and gonna work on the wave. We'll try to get Andy back on the line. That's not Draskal. Something very bad has happened to him. But Shadow Blade now on the Batrider. So we're gonna see Scandal with even more mobility here, plus has the gem as well. See if we can wake up the old man. I guess we're gonna try one more time here. But yeah, that was about as bad a free fight as it gets for Team No Diggity. It was with a quick black hole cancel there. Definitely a concern moving forward. You gotta figure they're a little frustrated, but this team has come back from big deficits. The question is, do they have the late game? I mean, we discussed it early on in the draft that wasn't the type of lineup that could necessarily just have a guaranteed auto win late game. You're up against Fear and Enigma, incredible control in the Batrider. I mean, really, if you look at Empire, have the better initiation, better vision heroes. Arguably, I mean, not more carries, but similar to better late game from the big teamfight ultimates, assuming they don't get wasted or interrupted, though. They come down to No Diggity outplaying them, with Koikpa needing to come up big, the Slark of Era still trying to find some pickoffs here. Only 2-2, he's been rather quiet for the start he had. Cinder, and we'll plop down an Observer Ward.
Alright, LD, can you hear me?
I can.
Alright, I don't know what's going on. Like, my internet is perfectly fine. It's just Skype hates me, I guess.
I think your computer's having an allergic reaction to these disastrous engagements by No Diggity.
Yeah, I saw, like, what happened in the last engagement, and it wasn't great. They canceled the Black Hole, but by the time it happened, it was already, like, way too much damage dealt. Just couldn't recover from that, so.
It looked so good, too. Like, they got the lane ward down, they saw the smoke, and then they still got crushed.
Yeah, I think it's one of those situations, because I think Mapushka actually got the Midnight Pulse down too before he cast Black Hole. And just the amount of damage that does channeling for even like 2 or 3 seconds, which I think is roughly what the duration was. You just lose so much health, and they didn't have any damage out on Ramzes either. He just is able to like run at people and focus them down, so.
Yeah, also, Kainar got a super fast hex off on the Doom when he blinked in. We had like a little choppy in the fight, but
yeah,
quick reactions by him as well. And they doomed Afterlife, but Afterlife just kind of sat back and nobody really focused him, so. Empire just very quick to react there. Just good individual skill, I guess, more than anything coming into play. There is a lasso, and they found a Koikpa. Hex is there. Kainar to follow, and they're doing this while the Roshan's also about to get finished off. So Empire having their cake, eating it too, collecting all the gold in the world. And now Ramsey suddenly up to 3,000 gold. I mean, who knows? Maybe he does go back for the Radiance here. He's pretty much got the Relic if he wants to.
Yeah, I think Radiance or Diffusal actually are both really solid choices. Diffusal for obvious reasons, it's really good at man-fighting the Slark. You kind of obliterate Doom as well. If you want to just jump him, you pop Manta Diffuse and he can't do anything about that. Like, even if you get the Doom off, you're still pretty much a goner, so. Still a really solid choice either way. It's a more fighting-oriented build, but I think with their lineup, like, the Spectre late game without a Radiance is still, like, really, really good. It's mostly just the idea that you can always be at the fight and you're always effectively farming that usually makes the Radiance better, because you're just getting, like, more GPM and more efficiency out of the map, but the fighting Spectre obviously works, too.
And fighting is what Ramzes wants to do. Grabs the Diffusal Blade here. And with that, Invoker becomes a much easier kill, so too does your Bane. Also worth mentioning, on top of everything else that went Empire's way, they got some good aggressive wards out now. One scouting the Slark. I mean, Era, probably one of the best heroes in the game to reveal them. See, we'll paint it out. Still, No Diggity are feeling like they're under the gun here. The meatball gets dropped in the mid lane. Ramzes, no haunt, but pressing forward, moving in. And he's going to get an Ion Shell as well. Black Hole available, Haunt, the only big spell missing, his finger is very close to cooling down, so effectively it's up. And in just a moment they might find Koikpa, he ghost walks, he does sense the gank coming. But Scandal, moving in. I even had a haster and could have tried to dive for that, but not going to in the end. Yeah, you can just see Empire, they're like piranhas, like a fresh piece of meat is about to be dropped in the pool, and they are just hungry for blood, and here they go, jumping in, looking for the vacuum combo with the Kale Follow. Didn't quite get the timing right there, but they're still going to dive. Big run to Kezu, big commitment for this one, and nothing to come for it. So, well, they were eager, but their eagerness got the best of them there.
That was a really nice defensive Nightmare, actually. Sunstrike kind of hit Ramses there, do a bit of damage, but without the Nightmare, I think Kezu dies there, like 100%. Or actually, he might have been able to BKB, so maybe the Nightmare only saves his BKB charge. Still, probably worth, they commit a lot, they don't get the tower, they're forced to back off.
And that tower bottom lane, looks like it will be denied by Afterlife, so a little more map control for Nodiggity, but less gold than ideal, and oh boy, Afterlife now grabbing the Lotus Orb here.
Oh, he had an Ultimate Orb already, didn't he?
I said Lotus Orb.
Oh, it's Lincoln's Sphere. Yeah,
Lincoln,
okay.
Sorry. Yeah, and you look at Nodiggity, very reliant on the single target initiation, be it the Grip, the Doom, I mean, even the, I guess, like, the Bane Sleep to set up, potentially, so big Lincoln's game.
Yeah, you can even throw it on Scandal, so like he can initiate, get the free lasso off into the Force Staff, and if the Bane is not like amazingly fast, you know, it's hard to get one spell off by the time that hero goes in. Getting two is very unlikely, so yeah, really good choice from him, for sure. Should allow them to get at least one or two good initiations.
Oh, chasing in with the Shadow Blade here, Scandal gets aggressive, and I'm starting to wonder if they have to buy a gem to deal with this, because he is just able to go wherever he wants, and he may track somebody down in just a moment. Throwing the Napalm out on the high ground here, confidently winding his way through the Radiant side of the map. Now Kainar gets to poke in, drops an Observer Ward. And although they hit Ramses in the mid lane, he's just going to chill. Clears out the wave, very confident. Aegis still has about a minute and change here. Quite a bit of time. Scandal looks for the leap. Shadow Blade poking in. Just creeping forward. They don't have vision of this. He doesn't have vision up the hill either. And nobody's going to reveal themselves. You mentioned it. The Lincoln's on the bat. He quickly throws down a Napalm, secures the tower, backs away. Such a good vision and control lineup here for Empire. And Nodiggity very much playing in the dark and playing defensively.
Yeah, the irony is the one hero they wanted to fight during this time is the Slark, and he doesn't want to be there because he wants to be farming elsewhere. If he's split pushing waves, yeah, you're not going to get picked off because you have great night vision, but at the same time, you're not really contributing to defending anything. So I don't know like what the point of no return is for the Slark. Like, does he want to just fight with his fresh 10-second BKB? Does he want to finish up like a Amp style or, you know, SOI?
Oh dear, Yapzor, Finger, and Haunt. That'll do it, and they're looking for more. They get the last one off on Kezu. Can they bring him down, though? Poker trying to counterplay this. It will match to bring down the Batrider. Now Ramses may be in too deep here, needs to run away. Dagger already committed. They try to bring him down with the Infernal Blade. Oh, gonna be close, but not quite enough. Ramses backing off and looking to turn it. He does get earned up and then runs back in. And now Afterlife Rise drops the wall as well. The Aegis, though, has dropped. They have a black hole, and Mapochka's in position. He may be able to go for this one. They blocked out Era. They go for the deeper black hole. He's going to find two. Who's going to cancel it? Cancel is the Doom, but he's not really in position to do so. And they've already lost 2-3. It's about to be 4. And Quake was going to go down as well. Nobody has buyback. Kezu could even be next if the Spectre chases him. Has the Defusal. Jumps back to the well. This might be the Rex. This might be the game. And Nodiggity. The Cinderella story may be ending here. Tier 3 bottom. Under siege. Mirana back, but that is going to be it for 28 seconds, and then to get the cores back, the true carries, you're looking at 40 plus, at least one lane, possibly even more, and Yapzor, you just can't get caught like that after the game he had, the start he had, he might die, stunned and dead, it's all falling apart, it's coming together for Empire at the same time, and this might be it, Andy.
Oh,
it'll be very hard to come back from here.
I mean, they have a tier 2 top, so I don't even know if they have enough time to even go mid, because the Slark is going to be up in 20, and so is the Invoker. That might be enough without the use of, like, Black Hole to be able to push them out on their own. But yeah, this is a very big amount of damage being taken here by Nodiggity. And I think that the team fight that they took, like, they were getting really overexcited that they managed to kill Ramses that one time, but they just commit too far, allow Mapochka time to get across the map and hit a nice Black Hole on the retreat. They just overcommitted a little bit. And the funny part about it was, like, Era turned around and didn't even go for the last hit on Ramses. Like, that was the part that was most shocking, is he didn't die until much later into the fight, so all things considered. I mean, they lose one set of racks. It's not like...
Oh, they are going to go in here. Cinderin, he leads the gank, and, well, he'll lead the death tally at this point as he racks up number 7, tied with only his own Mirana, but... I mean, like you said, that there we see it again. It feels like they're really pressing. Like they immediately lose their racks. They try to go for the long chase out of the base with the Moonlight Shadow, and the Batrider's just waiting and quickly gets a kill.
I think the Spectre is just like dealing more mental damage than it is like actually doing in fights. Because you play against that hero and you just, in the back of your mind, you always think, okay, we need to do something. We need to win. We need to get some kind of objective. But I think Slark going in the late game, obviously he functions differently than Spectre. The fights are a little bit slower paced for the Slark. He wants to, you know, get in and out. He wants to be able to stick to his target for longer periods of time, get Essence Shift going. But against Spectre, it's a little bit more difficult because the amount of damage that you take as soon as Haunt comes out and her ability to just jump on any hero she wants immediately just means that the fights have a tendency to last a shorter amount of time. So yeah, he still needs, I think, one extra item on top of what he has already to really start coming into his own. But if they can get that time, then, you know, we've seen bigger comebacks, right? Just in this series.
That is for sure. I guess the one thing that Empire will be thankful for is that they have the Dire side this time. So a little bit better access to the Roshan pit, and probably the dream hero to control the pit area with the Batrider, and a farmed Batrider at that. But, yeah, I mean, you're certainly right about that. We have seen No Diggity pull out some miracles already in this series. And for Empire... Now a Lotus Orb up on Afterlife, don't know if we mentioned that, but Lotus Orb Blinken, this is like the dream way to deal with the Bane and the Doom.
Yeah, you actually just can't use a spell on the hero anymore. If you have both of those, like, okay, one gets eaten, try to Nightmare yourself, try to grip yourself. It's not the most fun thing in the world to play against, but...
Unless you're some sort of crazy masochist.
we're Dota players, LD, we're all masochists, come on.
That's true. Alright, well then it's perfect. Just go for him. Throw everything at him.
Just YOLO. Speaking just of it. YOLO, diggity. Looking for they get a nice ward.
Okay. Yeah, it's good. I thought they were camping there for a second. A little bit dangerous against the bat, but they're gonna retreat out. All ultimates ready to go here for both sides. Full 5v5 clash. Who's gonna get the jump? Scandal in first. He just flies right over him. He's got the gem though, and now the hole. Who's gonna cancel it? He caught Kenzer too. This time he's gonna BKB. This time there's no counterplay for Koikfa. Three dead. Make it four as Koikfa just ain't running from the Batman. That's four down. Empire absolutely merciless as they butcher all No Diggity heroes who stand in their wake. And
that ward backfired so hard.
Oh, God.
It backfired so hard. The other four heroes were smoked, so they see the Spectre walking past the ward, and they just instantly Moonlight Shadow to try to kill him, right? Because they say, oh, okay, this is a potential pick. But they walk into a Shadowblade Gem Scandal, which sets up for a three-man Impale into Black Hole that the Doom walks into with BKB on and making it four. Oh my lord, I don't think there's any way that could have gone worse for No Diggity.
And this has to be heart-wrenching for them, for their fans, as they watch the mid-racks fall. Now two lanes of racks down against... I mean, frankly, one of the hardest late game lineups you will see, especially for a one carry draft, with arm on everyone. Even the Lion is closing in on an Aghanim Scepter at this point. The graph has just dropped off the face of the earth. It's gonna be a long climb back for No Diggity, and I mean, frankly, we're looking at like almost 10 minutes since their last kill. Actually more like 8 minutes since our last kill, but since the one before that, you're looking at 12 plus. So it has been a very long time since they've had any sort of foothold in this game.
I think it's just a lack of catch, you know? I was going back earlier to thinking about, you know, the Slark maybe buying a Blink Dagger. Not to say that it would have, like, totally changed the way the game played out, but I think having the option for the guaranteed initiation is just always nice when you have good follow-up. You know, you have, like, an arrow, you have a Doom to follow you up. There's just so many things that their lineup can do, I think, during the mid-game, and maybe they played it a bit too passive.
Well, aggression is what they want. No Diggity rushing back to the Rosh Pit, but the Black Hole is the only spell on cooldown right now. Haunt is up, the rest available. I mean, it was the spell that got them killed last fight, but let's see. They're still gonna commit for this. They're in the pit. They are grouped up. Cinder is tiny back. So they move forward. Ramsey just rushes in. He has no fear, this man. Radiant, Manta, and Diffusal, and now they get the lasso off. It's on Koikfa to start it. Kinar from the high ground finding the stun. Look for the finger. Koikfa's already low. His Lincoln's been popped. He's bursted down. Ramses, though, might be in trouble here. He does have the buyback. Instant buyback. Here comes the Haunt. Time for round two. Can they kill the Spectre a second time? Sleep. TP out. Sindra will escape. Afterlife doomed. Unable to get much done. But he Haunts again. Realitying forward onto Yapzor. Will kill him off. So it is two down. It looks like they should be able to at least secure the Roche. They're also on Dikazu here. And it's Scandal tracking him down again. Drop your gem crate. I'll take that too. It's a double gem special for Scandal. Everything's on sale. No diggity. Oh, it's a bit of a fire sale at this point. Three more deaths. It did force a Spectre buyback. And it ends up being a gold win for them. But that is not counting the Roche, which they're about to get.
It was a nice little effort there from the Diggity, just trying to get whatever they could, given their stage in the game. You know, you gotta go for a big play when you're behind. That's how they won the second game. That's how they were gonna come back into this game if there was ever a shot for it. But this time, Empire just came super prepared. They had buyback on the Spectre, which, interestingly enough, if he felt super cocky and didn't have buyback, I think Nodiggity actually could have won that fight. Because after the Spectre is dead, that's a huge chunk of your damage just gone. And then after that point, the Slark can kind of go for that longer team fight where he can go re-engage and get in and out and get those Essentia stacks that we were talking about. So it was actually a little bit closer than maybe people were thinking after watching what happened. But that's the difference between, you know, one carry being alive and having buyback and a Slark in a team fight.
And it just shows the importance of saving for it on a Spectre. And now has the Aegis. So Ramses with a second life to work with here. Did have to drop quite a bit of gold to get back into that one.
Yeah.
But I guess the other issue is that was without the black hole, and now they have it. Haunt coming in 20 seconds. They already have two lanes. And Empire, they're not going to wait for a whole lot here. It looks like take the tier 2 top, mid and bottom are pushing. And it just feels like they're going to try to go for this third lane right now. As Scandal, who's been the man of the hour, he's diving in so deep, but not quite hugging the tree line enough. Does get clipped by the tower there, and we'll end up backing off. Still though, any moment, the real action could break out. If Kill Ramses here, it'll be a dieback, but they got to do it twice. Jump in from Era, working on him. Ramses dismantling and engaging, and they are going to lasso Era. They're pulling him back in. The black hole comes through, but from Epochka, it's not really the best, but it's good enough. As Kezu hangs back, there's the double buyback. They need something for this. Black hole on cooldown, but Spectre still having Aegis. And they're moving in. Arrow, straight onto Scandal. He's up in front. The gem carrier as well. Can they turn this? Spectre just marching forward, working on Yapzor, slicing away with that spectral dagger. Should be enough to get the kill. But they get it to one. It's going to be a dieback on your Morana, I do believe, out of the game for quite some time. But Ramses has the second life, and he's got a Haunt. He pops it out.
Oh.
The back. The stun. The combo put in from Empire as they eviscerate Nodiggity. They've hexed up Era to bring him down as well. It's 5 dead and only a Doom with the buyback, and there's the GG. Nodiggity, so close. So close, but so far away in the end. Empire really had their number. Felt like this could have been a 2-0. They had to scrap and claw to force the game 3, and in game 3, it was just Empire having their number almost every fight. Man,
yeah,
Sor, what a start it was, but they just couldn't close it out.
The Spectre ended up being pretty integral to this victory. I would actually say if they did end up going with the Sven, it would have been the lesser of two evils, because Ramses just got way too much done in these teamfights. He's able to instantly get to the backline, which Nodiggity didn't really have a great answer to. It's like, okay, if he jumps the Bane either has to Nightmare himself or die. And that was pretty much, you know, what we kept